What's up you guys, it's me Trevor, back again for another video, and in today's video we're going to be going over the Justin Bieber wear, you know, hairstyle. Now you guys wanted to see this video months in the past, I'm just getting around to doing it today. I do apologize for the wait, but my hair is a good length right now, and I do have my roots coming in as you can see. So when he was filming that whole music video, he did have some roots, and his hair was a little bit longer than mine, but I have managed to make it work with my length. And we're not only going to be covering the hairstyle itself, but I did throw together a little bit of an outfit inspiration for you guys. So if you guys want to check out that as well, stay tuned. And we will be covering both of those topics. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. We're going to head over to the bathroom and we will get this hairstyle sorted out.
So to start off this hairstyle, you're going to want to start with wet hair. After that, you're going to towel dry it till it's about 30% dry. You're going to follow it up with a wide tooth comb just to comb it and get any sort of knots or tangles out of your hair. Once you have your hair going all the same direction, you're going to want to take some sort of heat protectant, whatever you prefer. I'm going to choose to use hairspray in this video just because it works the best for this hairstyle. It doesn't leave any sort of shine behind in my hair after. After that, you're going to take a matte finish paste, whatever you prefer as a pre-styler. I'm going to choose to use Mr. Pompadour's beeswax paste. You're going to take a small finger scoop, massage it into my hands, and then coat my hair in it. Once my hair is coated, I'm going to take my comb again and just saturate it all thoroughly throughout my hair. Note that I'm going the same direction again. After that, you're going to take your blow dryer and you're going to start blow drying your hair all in that same direction once again. The reason being behind this is that that's the way that my hair naturally grows and it doesn't give any sort of extra volume, which is good for this hairstyle. You can see me combing my hair forward and blow drying it and then all that same direction again. I'm really trying to limit the amount of volume I get, but I'm also combing it down to the side a little bit because he does have a layer of hair that falls down to the side. When you're done blow drying, you want to take your matte finish, medium to high hold paste. I'm going to use Mr. Pompadour's sculpting clay, small finger scoop, massage it all the way into your hands, and coat your hair completely down to the roots. When you have your product totally applied and you're starting to style it, you're going to want to pull a layer of hair down the side of your head just above your ear, and then you can layer your other hair on top of that to give it a little bit of depth. That's probably the most important point in trying to make this hairstyle look good. Now the last step is you can take another dry finish paste, this is Hans de Fuqua's quicksand, take a small finger scoop again, and notice that I'm not applying it down to the roots, just over the top of my hair. This is going to give my hair a little bit more of a dry finish, similar to what Justin Bieber had when he was doing this hairstyle. And that's the finished product. So now when it comes to this outfit, you can see I have this dark blue, black and white flannel with a white t-shirt and black denim underneath. The flannel is from Boathouse. Now, it was clearance. I think I got it for about 20 bucks, but I've seen a couple different flannels at different stores such as Zumiez, Forever 21, even West 49 and Blue Notes have had as well. Now, the t-shirt is just a white t-shirt from H&M. It was only about 10 bucks, pretty standard fit. And then the denim is also from H&M as well. These jeans did not come with any sort of distressing in them. I put those cuts in these myself because I wanted to give it a little bit more rugged look, but they do have some spandex in them, so they are stretchy and a little bit more comfortable as well. When it comes to the shoes, these are just an all-white Vans slip-on, pretty standard shoe, really good for summer, really comfortable, and I got these at Zumiez for about 60 bucks. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.